bright mark. I think it is Senna Sion in the bottom lane. Camille going to be the counter pick there up in top.
That's why I think the Galio ban made some sense. They had locked in Camille once before, and there's potentially calling that out. So nice prep there by C9. Notoriously difficult for melee matchups to deal with early on with his trial by.
Ooh, Fudge getting tagged. A bad time. The Fudge already burnt. Fudge! I think he bit off a little more than he could chew. Indeed he did. Boss is gonna...
Looks like Unicorns of Love should be able to secure this. So despite all the solo lane pressure that Cloud9 were applying in the early stages of their lanes, it does
feel to last very long. Liver's Joe not gonna get started. Boss already level 7. Gonna go in for it. And now C9 trying to fight back with Vulcan a little too low. TP coming in. That's a very nice TP ulti. Fudge actually does take up Boss, but Santa's in. Gets the ulti down. Fudge finds the flash. Flyman does fall as well, so it's a 1-for-1 so far. But maybe gonna be 2-for-1. Unicorns will love to secure the double perks. Oh, trying to make a massive play, but that is an overextension. Perks dancing back around. That might be all right.
Does have the W coming back up, but it's not there yet. And Unisig missing that Q and perks. He's just trying to run away. There's so much distance here between him and the incoming Mini Wave. Santa's going to get chained up. Perks trying to dance around it, but he can't dance for any longer as Santa's finally.
No man's.
Good ult to steal, actually. Grabs the Zin ult. Flabber now going to go in for it. TP coming through. Counter TP, though. Center ulti's nice also. The shutdown lands in for Vulcan. Now Fudge trying to fight out Boss here. His perks also in, but Sion, he's made his way up so speedily. Just zooms up there, and now Flabber is going to get absolutely deleted by the Camille as Boss finds the ulti and the kill. Fudge's Lowe's van is here, but I don't know if they've got anything under this tower. Fudge is not that healthy. Vulcan already used all his tools to engage. Cloud9 maybe going to go for it here, but have to Fudge. Fighting a Nunasik, but Blabber did drop the Herald in mid. It will make it here to take the plates. That's really nice for Perks to get a bit of extra gold. Yeah. So not wasted there for Blabber as Perks does chunk down Nomads. But again, UOL are in to try and save their mid laner, who is getting board time, but Nomad's gonna have to flash. And Nunasik finds the kick on his vent. Zen flashes back in. The root lands though out of center, and Boss is able to take that kill.
Nice job there. Turret plates. That's a massive Sion ult, even though it didn't hit. That's the greatest Sion ult miss I've ever seen.
Yeah, really nice. And now, tough side is going to happen again here. The center ulti's out. That's a big shield, but it's not enough to save Nomads. Blabber pops the ulti, flashes out of the way. Perks, a Vulcan Force flash as well, but another stick finds the trade. Nice and easy. Santa's here again, and Perks is just getting kind of hit on. I mean, Santa's is smacking him away. Can't really do anything.
This Herald going to be enough to grab that advantage. So this gold lead going to spike up. We'll see what it is after this hit happens, but looks like, not quite 2k, but getting close. 3v2 right now, though. Another sick. About to face check. Blabber looking for the kill. Perks are the one to claim it.
That everywhere.
Yeah, I'm very impressed with this so far. I mean, even Argonaut's Senna. There's so many times you watch a Senna ult come flying in. It's a local utility that she's able to bring when you're in these 1-3-1 lane setups, even when C9's the one making plays.
Stolen Gangplank ulti. Fog with my brain for a second. But...
yeah, it looked a little troll.
Perhaps weren't interested in contesting for it anyway, but now they're down 3 dragons and 1500 gold as Vulcan face checks, and he's just dead here. Looking for an engage, but not one he wanted. And Unisic gonna claim the kill.
Deep in enemy jungle.
Blabber baited over with the blast gun. The ball time is there. Senna ulti to try and disengage it, but Blabber's gotta run. There's nothing here. It's 5v4. Cloud9 are gonna be routed by Unicorns of Love. Nomads flashes in. He does get himself killed, but I think the follow up is well worth it. Two more now on the table for Unicorns of Love.
It's still a 4v4. Hold on, don't have time to talk about that.
Yeah, again, Nomads is getting targeted. C9 is trying to 3v1 any lane they can find and give themselves some gold. It's actually a 5v1 as Nomads steals a LeBlanc distortion, but that's not going to be enough. Does go back, it looks cute, but who's going to grab the kill? Who gets the donation? Nomads, it's going to be Fudge who collects.
Yeah, Fudge probably needs a little bit of help. For example, as a champion that can join in fights, it's like, well, I don't think you actually want to just blow your ult defensively in a fight you're going to lose anyways.
No, Boss, this looks real rough for Perks. Just easy solo kill.
I've been so impressed with their bot lane this game.
Oh, for sure. As Boss, again, has to weasel out of a 4v1. Kalda continue to find pickoffs, which is good. Boss a little too far forward, perhaps, and the kill will go over to Zven, who grabs the shutdown. That is
a
lot.
Really painful death to lose on your pretty fed Camille while giving C9 an opportunity to get pressure. Because if you have mid lane pushed, even if you die there, they don't get mid turret as well. Now, not only are you giving more or less in the area, have to see if they can.
It's 50. Another six in there. They're just gonna fight for the dragon. Who's gonna grab the soul? It is Blabber that gets the smite, but what does the fight look like at the end of it all? Full time over to the top. It's nice. On top of the GP ulti, Cloud9 team fighting their way out of the Dragon Pit as Perks is able to take down Sectors. Fudge now trying to turn Tailing Run because they've already lost two on the other side. It's Unicorns alive. The Wallet just too powerful. Fudge, they're going to get locked up and killed. A nice stun there for Vulcan is only going to delay the inevitable.
He just gets obliterated.
Here comes Sectors. Vulcan, very nice stopwatch. What's going to happen on the other end though? TP in Cloud9 doing it for everybody here, but now they've kind of committed themselves to the fight. Fudge in the middle of everyone as Unicorns alive are looking to make the play. GP ulti stolen there for Sars. Looks so good for Unicorns alive. Fudge already dead. Blabalo, Camille charging into the front lines. A nice stun there for Vulcan, but they still can't get the kills. The Nunnistic is going to try and assassinate Sven. He does get it done. And Unicorns alive just so aggressive, winning every single portion of the fight. Down the towers they go. They dive Cloud9 and smash them in that fight.
4-4-0 for Unicorns Love. They're TPing back in. 30-second death timers. I wonder if you're looking at the thing and end the game here. Maybe they're just grabbing Inhibitor and backing off the Baron. We'll have to see exactly how aggressive they want to get here, but they're looking pretty healthy. You have Senna to try and top people off.
Remember, this is for UOL's tournament life. If they don't win here, they cannot go any further in the play. And so they're going to try and make the play. Plava, he's trying to pull the wave. He's stopwatched. He's doing everything he can, but the ace finally comes through. Fudge is back alive. Rails up in 2 seconds, but Unicorns of Love, I think they've got it done. They do indeed have the Nexus in their sights. Cloud9 trying to defend as best they can, but they cannot do it. Unicorns 11 keeping